My name is Ted Kennedy. I am a research ecologist with the Grand Canyon Monitoring and Research Center in Flagstaff, Arizona. So my group did some synoptic food web studies from 2006 to 2009, where we described food webs throughout Grand Canyon, looking at algae and detritus and the invertebrates that eat those materials, and then the fishes too, and what fishes are eating. And what we found was that aquatic insects were key prey items everywhere. Just got me thinking, are there other ways that we can keep track of these animals besides, you know, professional scientists going and collecting samples ourselves? And that's where I got the idea for this citizen science-based project. So came up with a simple light trap device that catches the adult life stages of these insects after they've emerged from the river. And in working with professional river guides and private boaters, and also our own science trips, we have these folks deploy these traps each night while they're in camp, using standard protocols. And so we're able to keep track of the adult life stages, which tells us a lot about the animals, and the scope of the data set that we're able to acquire is much, much greater than we could do ourselves. So this image I'm showing here, all these dots represent collections by these various boaters. So we're getting 700 to 1,000 samples per year. The scope of what we could do on our own with river trips would be, you know, I would say 1/10 of that, because again, Grand Canyon's a national treasure, and you've got endemic endangered fishes living here, and we need to understand how these food webs and these ecosystems function, and if we can do that, then we can better manage them. Well, I grew up in the West. I grew up in California and was always fascinated by the Grand Canyon and the Colorado River. I grew up in Los Angeles, and so water and the West, you know, that's a big issue in the West. And I ended up, going out to Minnesota for my PhD work, but, I ended up doing my dissertation in Nevada, actually, in a place in the Mojave Desert, looking at salt cedar and how that non-native tree affects, you know, stream food webs. So looking at interactions between terrestrial aquatic linkages, basically. And when I saw this job advertised back in 2002, I jumped at the chance, you know, to work in Grand Canyon on these food webs here, and to do work that was, you know, very applied, right? Where we're trying to improve the health of the river and understand the factors that are driving fish populations. That was just really appealing to me, to get to, you know, to do fundamental basic science, but then to have an avenue for presenting those results directly to the folks that are making decisions about how the dam is managed. That was a very exciting opportunity for me.